What's going on, everyone? I'm back here with another video, and today I'm going to be making a third update to what's in my camera bag. So since the last video I made, I've actually accumulated quite a bit more equipment over the course of the past several months. So I thought I'd go ahead and make another update to the what's in my camera bag video. So yeah, that's what's going to be going on here. So let's go ahead and get started. So first thing we can know that we see right away is I have a new camera bag itself. The previous one, which is much smaller than this and was not able to carry as much equipment. So I needed to upgrade to a larger size. So that is actually kind of what this does. So this is kind of like a duffel bag size. And it's made by XIT, as you can see there. And I got it off of eBay for about $50. It's actually a pretty good deal. But anyway, let's go ahead and get started. So we're going to go ahead and start with this top portion here. So first thing, I'm going to start with some of So I'm going to start with this compartment here on the left side. So first thing I've got in here is my iView camera glasses. I did make an unboxing of this about a couple years ago. And basically what these are a pair of camera glasses that you wear, and they can record high definition video of basically whatever you're doing. This is a external flash that you mount on top of the camera. It is made by Altura, and it is basically a professional grade external flash. As you can see here, this mounts on your camera's hot shoe, and it gives you much better lighting and control over the lighting in the current situation that you're in. Okay, so moving on further into this compartment, so taking off this little Velcro thing, this is where I have my 70-200 2.8 lens from Sigma. I got this used off of eBay for about, I think, $850. So for the price, it was really, really good deal. And so far, it has served me very well for all of the photo shoots that I've used this with. It is going strong and is a super nice lens and can give you really, really sharp images. So this is another thing I would really, really highly recommend picking up. Okay, moving on to the next compartment. This here is a set of macro extension tubes. I did make an unboxing of this as well if you guys want to check it out. Now, basically what macro extension tubes do is you mount any of these three onto your camera, and then you mount the lens onto this end here. As you can see, it's got the standard Nikon F mount, and you can pick this up for both Nikon and Canon cameras, depending on whichever one you have. But basically, this gives you the ability for your lens to focus much, much closer to a subject than it originally can. Okay, moving on. Down here, we have the charger for my camera. And then lastly, down here is a lens. So this is the Nikon 50mm f1.8G prime lens. I got this for about $170 new off of adoramacamera.com. And this lens is such a good lens for that price. It offers some really nice sharp images as well as some nice blurred backgrounds. This is definitely a lens that you should think about picking up because it can really, really make your photos look really, really nice. All right, so moving on to the next compartment. Over here, I have just a little basic LED flashlight. This is nice if you intend on doing night photography and long exposures. Next up is a set of pop-up flash diffusers. So basically what this is you'd mount this on the hot shoe on top of your camera. As you can see here, you have a little mount there. And you would basically, this covers the front portion of the pop-up flash on your camera and diffuses the light from it. So it basically spreads out the light in a greater area. Moving on, I have here is a standard USB SD card adapter. Next up, I have a shutter release cable, and it's a really basic one. You just plug it into the side of your camera using this connector here. It gives you the ability to trigger your camera's shutter without actually needing to press the shutter button. And then lastly, down in here, I have some spare AA batteries that I've kind of wrapped up in tape so they don't kind of fall all around in the bag. But basically I use these for my secondary camera, which I have in this compartment, which I'll show in just a second. Okay, now moving on to this compartment here. And this is where I store my kind of point-and-shoot type cameras. So this here is a Sony Cybershot DSC-T99. And it's basically just a little compact camera that you can easily put in your pocket and off and go. And it's super portable. I mean, you can see it's really, really small. And it does offer really nice image quality for the price. I've actually had this for about 6 years. And actually, it's done really well. And then right on top of here, this is the charger for that Sony Cybershot camera. And then over here, lastly, this is the camera I was talking about that uses those AA batteries. This is the Nikon Coolpix L810. It's a point-and-shoot camera. It's all digital and all automatic. It has no manual controls whatsoever. But the thing I like about this is it has a really, really impressive zoom on it. I believe it has the equivalent of a 1200mm zoom, if you were to translate that to a DSLR. So the zoom on this thing is incredible, and I think I only paid about $200 for this. So for that price and the amount of zoom that this allows you to have is insane and really, really nice. So you could probably pick this up used for about $100. Okay, moving on. So I'm going to start back on the left side over here. So right here in this compartment, I have another lens. This is the Nikon 55-300 f4.5-5.6 telephoto zoom lens. I picked this up off of Adorama Camera for about $210. A really, really good deal, and it is used. I bought it Nikon refurbished. And this lens, the amount of zoom that this gives you is absolutely insane. For the actual, for the size of this lens, the zoom range is really, really crazy. Next to that, we have this little carrying bag here. This is where I store my extra batteries. So if I pull one out here, you can see this is where I put my spare batteries for my camera. It's always nice to have a few of these on hand. So if you're out shooting and your camera ends up dying, you can easily have a battery on hand. Next is a little air duster. I've showed this previously, so I'm not going to go into too much detail with it, but I use this to get dust and dirt off of my camera and the mirror on the inside if I'm shooting in a really dusty environment. Lastly, in this compartment, I have a little body cap, lens cap combo thing here, and basically this houses my extra memory cards. So I've got a couple of them in here right now. I've got the 32 gig and an 8 gig SD card in here, just in case if I need it. Next up, I have this little knife right here. It's just a basic little flip-out knife, as you can see, from Winchester. Basically, I use this as a precautionary measure. I do go to horse shows quite often, and that's kind of my main area of photography. And you never know when a horse might get caught up in a rope or need to be cut away from something, because that does tend to happen sometimes. They might get themselves wrapped up in a rope or something, and you might need to cut it loose. So it's, in my case, it's nice to have a knife for that particular reason on hand. Next is just a basic little pen if I need to write something down. And then lastly is a lens pen. And again, I made a video on this a few months ago, but basically it is a lens cleaning device. And on one end, it has a retractable brush, and on the other, it has a cleaning tip that you rub on the front of your lens to remove fingerprints. Moving on, I've got another lens here. So this is an older lens. I've showed this actually quite often in some of my other videos, but basically, this is the Nikon Series E 50mm f1.8. It was made between the 1970s and the 1980s, and it is an all-manual lens, which means the focusing is all manual, and the aperture control is also all manual. So nothing is controlled by the camera. It is all controlled by the user. And then below that, I have another lens. This was another old lens that I picked up off of eBay for about $55, and basically this one was made in the early 1970s. And this one is the Nikkor Q 135 f2.8. Again, this is an all manual lens, just like the Series E 50mm. As you see, the focusing is all manual, and as well as the aperture control again. So, again, the image quality that comes out of this lens is just spectacular. I mean, nothing can really beat the build quality and image quality of these older lenses. I mean, they are just built like a tank and can withstand a pretty substantial amount of beating. And it's just all around a really good lens. So, if you're lucky enough, you can find these on eBay for a relatively cheap price. Now, if you're wanting to find one in a pretty decent condition, it's going to probably run you about $100, $150, maybe even $200 for a lens like this. So be aware of that, but do keep searching on there. You might get lucky and find one for a really, really cheap price. So on to the last compartment in this top portion here. Right here is the actual camera itself. I'm not going to go into too much detail on this because I've made actual several videos regarding this camera. But what I have here, the combination that's currently on here, is the Nikon D5500 DSLR, as well as the 18-140 kit lens. With the detachable hood that I actually had to purchase separately on Amazon for, I believe, about 10 bucks. And then I have this here. This is, again, I've made a video on this prior, but basically this is a little bubble spirit level that you put on the hot shoe, which acts both as a dust cover as well as a level. Okay, so moving on to this front compartment here. So if I unzip this, I've actually got several things in here. First being is the charger for those camera glasses that I showed earlier. Next up is the USB cable for the camera. And then this here is a filter kit. Now I have three of them in here. I've got a circular polarizer, a UV filter, and a FLD, which is mainly used for film cameras. It's not really that useful on digital. And the next up is the Zikos macro filters. That go on to the front of the lens, and these are actually 64 millimeter in size. And basically, if I take one of these out here, as you can see, it's actually got some fingerprints on it, but basically what this allows you to do is it screws on to the filter thread on the front of your lens, and it gives you instant macro functionality to that particular lens. Now the downside of this is it only works with lenses with a 67 millimeter thread. So this will not work on just any lens that you want to put it on. So be aware of that when purchasing this. This here is a little lens cap strap. I don't pretty much ever use this. That's why it's still in the retail packaging. But basically, this would allow you to strap the lens cap to your camera so you don't lose it. Now this is only useful if you are not someone like me that uses multiple lenses and is swapping lenses very frequently. So that would only be useful for those that put one lens on their camera and basically leaves it there. Next is a standard microfiber cloth. And moving over here, this is another set of filters. Again, I have a UV filter, which is actually on one of the lenses right now. And then another circular polarizer, as well as a ND filter number 2, which reduces the amount of light coming to your lens. Next up is a little pouch that is full of miscellaneous little pieces of gear. Another thing is some tripod screws that are double-sided. And then in here I've got some 1/4 inch to 3/4 inch adapter screw for a tripod. And then lastly in here are some spare those little bubble levels that I showed earlier. All right, moving on. I'm not going to take this out once again because I've already showed it quite often, but this is my little notebook that I use to write down camera settings for different situations that I may be in. So that's a really nice thing to have. And then lastly over here, I just have some cleaning materials. I've got some cotton swabs. And then I've got this here, which is actually meant to go on a smartphone. But basically what this is it's a little clip-on lens set. If I can get this off here. So you see, it's a clip-on lens set that you clip onto the rear camera of your smartphone. And basically, it gives you different effects for your smartphone. So this one is a fisheye, and then there's also a wide angle as well as a macro. All of which work actually quite surprisingly well for them being a super cheap little lens that you can just pick up for about 10 bucks. Okay, now moving on to the first of the two side compartments. And in here, I've got a few more little just small things. The first being is a Hot Shoe smartphone mount. I use this to mount my iPhone 7 on. And basically, it would allow me to record video and take pictures at the same time. So I essentially have my phone recording video, and then I'd be using the camera itself to be taking the photos. So I can be basically recording video and taking photos simultaneously. So it's a really neat. Next up is the Apple Lightning to SD card adapter. Being that I do use an iPhone, this is a nice device to have because if you want to transfer your pictures or video from your camera over to your smartphone, or your iPhone in this case, to share on a social media site or something of such, this is a handy little device. You can pick up off eBay for about $30, and it lets you transfer full resolution photo and video to your iPhone, or basically any iOS device using this Lightning connector. Next up, I have a few of these spare adapters for that smartphone tripod mount. Right here, I've got an AV cable. And then another thing, I've got the Nikon wireless remote trigger. And I use this to wirelessly trigger the shutter on my camera without needing to touch it. It kind of serves the same function as that shutter release cable that I showed previously. But this one is totally wireless. And then the last few things down in here, first being is a tripod Hot Shoe adapter. Next up is an SD card to micro SD card adapter. And then I have this here, which is a viewfinder cap or cover, which goes over the top of the viewfinder on the camera to protect it from dust and scratches if I'm going to be storing the camera for a long period of time. All right, now moving on to the last compartment. In here, I don't have too many things, but first of being is an iPhone charger. So it's nice to have this on hand just in case I need to charge my phone. And then I have a miniature sized tripod, which I use to mount an external light source or an external flash, like I showed earlier. This really works great for that, and it is made by Targus. I believe you could pick this up from Walmart for about $15. It seems kind of a lot, but the build quality is actually really nice, and it's a nice thing to have. Another thing in here is a 30-pin connector cable. To go with that USB cable is an iPhone 4. And this I use to mount on that Hot Shoe adapter. And I would mount this on here, and this is what I record video with. It only records 720p, but for what I'm using it for, it works perfectly fine. Another thing that I don't actually keep in the camera bag itself is this ball head tripod mount. This is usually stays permanently affixed to my tripod. But I went ahead and took it off for this video. It is made by Pergear, and it is a tripod mount that uses a ball head. So you unscrew this. As you can see, it gives you full 360-degree movement for your camera. So you can basically move the camera around in multiple different directions and have it be really, really smooth. All right, so that is basically it for this video. Now, this video has turned out to be relatively long, and I was kind of expecting that because there was a lot of equipment to go over. But yeah, that's basically it for this video. Now, I will make another update video in the future once I accumulate a little bit more equipment, which I do expect to happen. But yeah, that's basically it for this particular video. I hope you guys have enjoyed. Again, I will provide links to everything that you've seen here in the description below if you guys are interested. But yeah, that's basically it. I hope you guys have enjoyed it once again. Hit that subscribe button right down below. It is much appreciated and greatly helps out the channel. Also, hit that like button. It is also greatly appreciated. And if you guys have any questions, comments, or anything of such, drop them below, and I will get back to them as soon as I possibly can. But yes, with that all being said, hope you guys have enjoyed once again, and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace out.